In this video, we'll discuss regarding compression plates and non-compression plates. Okay, compression plates are nothing but they have the ability to compress the fractured fragments after plate fixation. Okay, whereas in non-compression plates, they just hold the fractured fragments in line. That's all. They do not compress. Okay, we generally use non-compression plates. That is, mini plates or reconstruction plates all comes under non-compression plates. Okay, the compression plates, the main advantage is there is additional stability. Okay, if you fix two compression plates, it becomes under the rigid type of fixation. There is additional stability due to the frictional interlocking between the fractured fragments, because the fractured fragments are compressed. So there is, due to the bony interface, there is something frictional interlocking. So it produces additional stability, the only advantage of compression plates. Okay, so it comes under rigid type of fixation. Then the disadvantage is overriding of the fractured fragments, especially if you fail to adapt the plate to the underlying bone. The main precautionary measure we have to do regarding compression plate is there must be precise adaptation of the plate to the underlying bone. If there is no adaptation, then it will produce overriding of the fractured fragments. Okay, fractured fragments, instead of in line, they become overrided. And especially after overriding, it will produce malocclusion. It may be intraoperative or postoperatively, but it produces malocclusion. Then indications, there are some specific indications where you have to use the compression plates. Okay, generally compression plates are not recommended or not routinely used. We routinely use non-compression plate. So when there is minimal obliquity, okay, the fracture should be minimally oblique. That means it is somewhat straighter. In those cases only you can use the compression plate. And another is sound bony buttresses. That means if there is defect fracture, that means gap between the fractured fragments is too much, or there is defect, bone loss, then you can't use the compression plates. There should be sound bony buttresses to provide the frictional interlocking. If there is no sound bony buttresses, it will result in overriding of the fractured fragments. Okay. And the coming to the contraindications, when there is defect fracture, that means when there is bone loss in the fractured fragments, then you cannot use the compression plates. And severe oblique fractures, as I told, the fracture should be minimally oblique, then only you can use the compression plates. This point is disadvantage. This point is disadvantages of compression plate. There is widening of the mandible, especially towards the lingual cortex. Okay, when there is widening in the lingual cortex, it will produce widening of the gonial angles also. Oh, this is also one of the disadvantages of compression plates. Then these compression plates works on the principle of spherical gliding principle. Okay, spherical gliding principle. If you take an angled cylinder like this, okay, this cylinder is angled and there is some horizontal part also. And if you place a spherical, if you place a sphere within this cylinder, first it moves obliquely downwards and then it follows a horizontal direction, right? In an angled cylinder, if you place a sphere, first it moves obliquely downwards, after that it follows a horizontal direction. Exactly same thing happens in the screw or screw hole in the compression plates. The compression plates hole is essentially the middle part, corresponds to the middle part of this cylinder. Okay, so there is like this middle part of the cylinder. So you can see in this, this is the fractured fragments, this one fragment and another fragment, and this red color are the compression plates. So you can see here, this is the compression hole. This is the compression hole. So this compression hole is like this. First it has angled or inclined plane, then it becomes somewhat horizontal like this. Exactly you can see in here. Okay, so first screw is fixed from this point. Entry point of the screw is here. As you fix the screw, it becomes or it rotates obliquely in a inclined plane obliquely downwards and then follows the horizontal direction. So when it follows the horizontal direction, fractured fragments gets closer to produce the compression of the fractured fragments. You can see this is the gap between the fractured fragment, and this gap is totally gone after the screw fixation by the compression produced by the screws. Okay, so this is the working principle of compression plates based on the spherical gliding principle. If you remember this, then it is easy to understand. Okay, so there are two types of compression plates. First one is dynamic compression plate and eccentric dynamic compression plate. First we'll see dynamic compression plate. Dynamic compression plate has two compression screws, two compression holes and two retentive holes. These red lines are the red screws, red holes are the compression holes. Compression holes are somewhat ovoid like this. They are parallel to the long axis of the plate. They are oriented parallel to the long axis. That means this one. Okay. This is the long axis of the compression plate. Okay. They are arranged along this axis. And they are somewhat ovoid, not circular. Okay. Whereas retentive holes are the circular ones. Okay. So there are two compression holes and two retentive holes in the dynamic compression plate. First, we have to fix the two compression holes. After that, we have to place the retentive holes. Compression holes produces compression, and retentive holes produces just retention of the plate. Okay, but the major disadvantage of dynamic compression plate is, ideally, this dynamic compression plate should be placed along the upper border, that is alveolar border. But due to the presence of the teeth and inferior alveolar canal, we place it along the lower border. So when you are placing dynamic compression plate along the lower border, there is suppression along the upper border. It produces suppression along the alveolar border. That is suppression of the fractured fragments along the alveolar border. So you have to fix one mini plate or some type of tension band. Maybe it may be the arch bar to counteract this effect. So after placing dynamic compression plate, you have to place one mini plate here. Okay, one mini plate should be placed to counteract this widening at the alveolar border. Instead of this mini plate, you can use arch bar fixation also on the teeth. That acts as a tension band. That means some type of tension band should be there when you are using dynamic compression plate to counteract the superior border suppression. Okay, this is the main disadvantage of dynamic compression plate. And it has two compression screws which are somewhat ovoid and two retention screws. They are circular. Okay, now we will discuss about eccentric dynamic compression plate. Eccentric dynamic compression plate is a 6-hole plate. Okay, it has two additional screws which are placed obliquely. That is the only difference between EDCP and DCP. Okay, first it has two compression holes which are ovoid, placed along the long axis of the plate. Okay, then next to that compression holes, we have two retention holes. Okay, until this part, this is the dynamic compression plate. Okay, and the next two screws, these are the obliquely placed screws. Okay, you can see here, this is okay, these are placed obliquely, not along the long axis of the plate. Okay, these are the obliquely placed screws, obliquely placed holes. Okay, this is the only difference between dynamic compression plate and EDCP plate, right? These obliquely placed holes produces compression at the alveolar border of the mandible. Okay, when you are fixing the plate, this produces the fixation of screws in the obliquely placed holes produces compression at the alveolar border also. That prevents separation at the alveolar border. That means to avoid the disadvantage of DCP, EDCPs came into the role. Okay, so there is no need to place a mini plate along the upper border or alveolar border below the root apices, or there is no need to place a arch bar on the teeth. Okay, arch bar can be placed for the help to gain the intermaxillary fixation, but as a tension band there is no need. There is no need of tension band when you are fixing the eccentric dynamic compression plate. One plate is enough. It produces rigid type of fixation. Only one plate produces rigid type of fixation. This EDCP is indicated in cases of edentulous fractures where there is no teeth, so you can't place a arch bar, or due to the less bony length or less bony height, you can't use two plates. Okay, and partially edentulous plates, fractures. In edentulous fractures, in partially edentulous fractures, this eccentric dynamic compression plate is utilized. So generally, compression plates are sparingly used, that is rarely used. We generally use non-compression plates. And there are two types in compression plates: dynamic compression plate, eccentric dynamic compression plate. Okay, I told what is the difference between these two. And one more type of one more way to produce the compression of the fractured fragment is lag screws fixation. With two lag screws, we can produce some compression at the fractured ends. This is all about compression plates. If you like this video, hit the like button, share the video, subscribe the channel.